Hey guys, it's Gretchen, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is another piercing related video. You're welcome. Today I thought I would talk a little bit about gauges and what exactly they are and what are standard sizes for just piercings. Because a question I get often is, I just got such and such piercing done. My piercer didn't tell me what gauge it is. I forgot to ask. I don't want to go back and ask. What is a standard size? So I'm here to answer those questions today. So what exactly is a gauge? What does it refer to? A gauge is basically the thickness of jewelry or the piercing site. So typically standard lobes are like 22 or 20 gauge. So the sizing for gauges kind of works in reverse in the sense that the larger the number is, the smaller the hole. So when you have an 18 gauge piercing site, it's gonna be a pretty small one compared to something that's like a 2 or a 0 gauge. The higher the number, the thinner the jewelry, as well as the lower the number, the thicker the jewelry. That is until you get into like inches for your lobes if you're stretching them. And that typically happens once you reach like 00 gauge. And then after that, it becomes its own animal. But today's video, I'm not focusing on ear stretching so much as I am on just what is a standard size for any other piercing. So like, what is a standard size gauge for a lip piercing, an eyebrow piercing, cartilage piercings, nose piercings, you name it. I'm hopefully gonna touch on it. There may be some that I missed, such as down there, because I honestly don't know. Like in my research that I did regarding this, because obviously I don't have all of these piercings, so I don't personally know what the standard size is. So I did a little bit of research. The down there area varied from site to site. So you might wanna look into that one yourself. I think I got a sense of like 16 or 14 for that down there. So like I said, once it hits like that 00 gauge mark, that's when it kind of becomes actual measurements. So until that time, it's in gauge sizing. I don't know what this was, but after that it becomes true measurements. But that's not what we're focused on right now. So what kind of determines what gauge size you get initially? Typically, it's what a piercer assesses from not just the piercing that you've selected and want to have done, but kind of like the anatomy and how that area looks. So a piercer, if they look at say your nose and they think that you would do better with a 20 gauge piercing as opposed to an 18 gauge piercing, they may make that call. Sometimes they'll ask you and be like, hey, are you okay with this sizing? If you're not, do speak up, because I mean, it is your body that's getting stabbed. You might want to say what you're thinking. I actually had that happen with my mid helix. All of my other cartilage piercings, aside from my conch, are 16 gauge. Well, when the piercer went to do my mid helix, he went to do an 18 gauge. I was not about that life. I wanted a 16. I wanted it to all be the same. The reason why he had picked 18 at first was because it is a little bit of a tighter space in here, right here. But he said a 16 gauge would work, which it does. Even if your piercer assesses an area and determines that they think this certain size would be better, if you prefer something else, do speak up. Because once again, it is your body and you're the one getting stabbed. You might want to be happy with it. Piercers also have to look at the thickness of the skin as well as the cartilage. Some people just have super thick skin and super thick cartilage compared to someone who may not. Now, I personally don't know if that contributes anything to pain levels or that crunching sound that people often talk about, which I've never really heard. My internal cartilage piercings, I hear a little bit more just because it's right next to the canal. I don't know if like the thickness of the skin as well as the cartilage contributes to whether or not it's painful or whether or not you hear that sound. But that's a different thing entirely from gauges. The rest of this video is me just gonna be going over what I have found to be the most standard sizing for certain areas that get pierced. Again, I don't have all of these piercings, so I don't personally know. This is just what I found in, you know, a little bit of research online. So if you've gotten a piercing and your piercer, you know, didn't tell you or forgot to tell you what size they pierced you with, this is just a standard, not set in stone. Take this with a grain of salt. Do not take my word for it. Anything else? Okay. Also, these are in no particular order. They were just kind of how I found them. So the first one is your navel slash belly button. Typically a navel belly button, that was repetitive, but a navel piercing is a 14 gauge or a 12 gauge. When I had mine done briefly, rip, it was a 14 gauge. But they can go to be about a 12 gauge. I'm pretty sure that's a general standard. Especially like, something else you can figure out is if you go on a site that sells jewelry, like Urban Body Jewelry, Body Art Forms, Body Candy, anything like that. If you search by jewelry, like by piercing site, it'll typically be like, you know, off on the side, you can filter out the size and it'll be like 14 gauge, 289 items. 12 gauge, 75 items, and you can kind of see from there what the standard is, you know, what they have more of in stock. But yes, so the navel piercing is typically a 14 gauge or a 12 gauge. Next is your eyebrow. Eyebrows are typically 18 or 16 gauge. I believe it leans more toward the 16 gauge, but they can be as tiny as an 18 gauge. Again, it depends on your anatomy, the thickness of your skin, how it would look. You know, you don't want something super massive, kind of like leaning against your eye. That wouldn't be cool. You couldn't see. Not saying that a 16 gauge is that big, but you also don't want it to be like sucked in by your eyebrow. Not saying an 18 gauge would do that, but you get what I'm saying, right? Right, okay. Next is cartilage, which is the one that I always get the most questions about. This typically ranges from a 20 gauge to a 14 gauge. There is a pretty big range there. Typically, cartilage piercings are a 16 gauge. However, that is not always the case. My conch was pierced as a 14 gauge because the piercer thought that this site, you know, is big enough that if I did want to size down, I could. But he thought that a 14 gauge would be better there. That is not a standard size. That's my only oddball one. The rest are standard because they are all 16 gauge. So, if you have recently gotten a cartilage piercing and you have no idea what it is, I would guesstimate a 16 gauge, but again, that's just a standard. Earlobes. These typically range from 22 gauge to an 18 gauge. They're typically the smallest ones that you'll get. And that's just because this is pure flesh. Pure flesh. No cartilage or anything. And if you want to go bigger, you can follow in plenty of other people's footsteps and stretch them. It's a lot of fun. I'm enjoying it. Everyone's telling me I need to go to a 00. Stop peer pressuring me. Because I might. Next are the nipples. Typically these are kind of like your navel in that they are a 14 gauge or a 12 gauge. I think most people do the 14 gauge, much like the navel. I don't know. My nips are not done. But those are the standard sizes, 14 or 12 gauge. Lip piercings, which I don't have my fake one on today, sorry. These are typically 18 or 16 gauge. If you want a more dainty look, you can do a 20 gauge. I'm pretty sure that when I get my lip done, and I'm not saying if, when, damn it. When I get my lip done, it'll probably be a 16 gauge. That's just because that's the standard at the shop I go to. Tongue, these are typically 14 or 12 gauge, much like your nipples. Your tongue is usually 14 or 12. I don't know which way that typically leans. I wanna say 14, much like the navel and the nipples, but I'm not entirely sure. But those are the two standard sizes that people usually get. Dermals, these fun little things, you know, the ones that are like anchored into your skin that I would most likely rip out of me. These are usually 18 to 12 gauge. I don't know how big dermals can get. I guess they can get pretty big, but those are the standard sizes, like 18 to 12 gauge. So in that range, they're so cute, but I know I'd rip it out and that would suck. Cheek piercings. These are typically 16 to 12 gauge. You know, the smaller it is, the more dainty it looks. The larger it is, the little bit more out there it looks. And out there is not supposed to be a negative thing. Don't anyone take that as a negative thing. But they'll just be more noticeable. There you go. Again, I don't have cheek piercings, so I have no idea if that's correct. But that's just what I found in my research. Industrial piercings. So this is separate from helix piercings just because I find that they are kind of their own little animal, their own little category, if you will. Industrials range typically from a 16 to a 12 gauge, so they are a little bit larger than the standard cartilage piercing. I honestly don't know the reason why for that, because it's basically just two cartilage piercings that end up connecting by a bar. So I don't know why they vary like that, but that's just what I have found. I have a friend who has an industrial, and I'm pretty sure it's a 14 gauge. You know, the rest of cartilage piercings are 16. That one tends to be larger for whatever reason. Nostril piercings, this is a big one that I get often. What is my nostril piercings gauge size? Blah, blah, blah. These range from 20 to 16 gauge, typically. Mine is an 18 gauge, and I'll tell you one thing, it is hard to find any cute tiny stones in an 18 gauge online, like any of the shops. It's very difficult. They're typically 20 gauge, so they lean more toward the tiny side. It's very hard to find an 18 gauge, but I've found some, and then I just typically stick with them. But yes, so nostril piercings, typically 20 to 16, more so toward that 20. Septum piercings, these little fun buggers, they range from 18 to 14 gauge. Typically, again, like cartilage piercings in your ears, the standard is right in the middle at that 16 gauge. That is what mine is. I've had someone ask me if I want to stretch my septum before. Nah, I'm good. I'm good with my 16 gauge, but a lot of people do. But the standard, like starter size, is 16 gauge. And the last one I'm going to touch on is your bridge, which is this fun little area right here. See up here? Your bridge. This is typically an 18 gauge or a 16 gauge. I think it leans more toward the 16 gauge. If you want to take up less space up here, an 18 gauge would be more of the route you want to go to. So these are just some of the most common piercings that I found in my research that are discussed at what their standard sizes are. Again, I don't really know what the area is. I think it's like a 14, like 14, 12, which that's just massive for that area. Like, damn. So it might be more like 16 to 12. But again, I don't know that one so much. I'm sure there are a bunch more that I missed, and I generalized cartilage piercings, so I didn't pinpoint each cartilage piercing. But yeah, so if you've recently gotten a piercing, you don't know the size that it is, you forgot to ask your piercer forgot to tell you, you don't want to go back in just to ask that question. These are typically the standard sizes of what they are pierced initially. Now you can always size up and you can always size down. If you are not happy with the initial size, you can change it. Let me know in the comments below what your piercing gauges are that your body has. Like I said, the majority of mine are 16, though I do have a 14, and I do have some 18s. So let me know in the comments below if you have any piercings that kind of go outside of that standard sizing, because like I said, my conch kind of falls outside of the standard sizing by being a 14. But that is it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a big ol' thumbs up. Go on down there and hit that subscribe button wherever it may be, because I don't know, even though I do, this is just my shtick now. Also hit that notification bell in case you want to know when I upload, and in case YouTube wants to let you know when I upload, because I would really appreciate it. And until next time, bye guys.